We are in a mode of divine visitation. Praise the Lord. Divine visitation. Every visitation is with an expectation. Every visit. Amen.
Amen.
Every visit. Visitor coming to your house is with an expectation, either from you or from him. Amen.
Amen.
If the president of our country says he wants to visit River City, everybody will be prepared. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
They will put things in order. Like our dad said, there is always preparation when you are expecting a visitation. You don't just sit down when you hear that Jesus is coming to you, say, okay, let him come. You will keep things on care. You will put things in order so that when he comes, you will appreciate what you see. Amen. Your expectation may be an appreciation. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You come and see what you have done and say, well done. You have done well. Amen.
Amen.
So many years back, when our father in the Lord of blessed memory, Archbishop of Blessed, also was expecting Dr. Maurice Ogudo of blessed memory to now to visit him. When Dr. Ogudo said, T.A. Osborne, when he was coming, he said, I am visiting Nigeria and I'm coming to your place. Archbishop took time to decorate everywhere, put the place in order, they bought cabal and decorated the stones, put everything in order, expecting Dr. T.A. Osborne to visit. When the Lord came, praise God. That was when Papa was saying that God's own palace. No, the Lord's big mansion. Before he moved to God's own palace. When the Lord was grown and came, getting in spite of every preparation, Papa did, when he got to the place, he saw the entrance, saw the decoration. Papa, you have put effort. The police said, no, I can't enter here. Praise God. He said, I can't come in here. What kind of place? What is this? A man of your status. No. He said, I won't enter here. Papa said, so bad. Amen. After putting things in order, how much more of you that is just sitting down, doing nothing? You know how the soul, blessed is to expect nothing, you shall not be disappointed. When you are not expecting anything and nothing happens, will you be offended? Will you be disappointed? No! I remember it clearly, when the young papa was sharing with us, come and see our papa in tears, my God. He was in tears when he remember everything back in the old God. The level of you were just here counting the experience. That was somebody expecting something. Well prepared was the visitor when he came. He said, no, this is not visiting. Praise the Lord. How much more of our God visiting your home? How prepared are you? Amen. For this visit. How prepared? When God money. He was saying, don't look at my now. Don't complain because I don't have money and say I'm poor. So it's not about money. Praise the Lord. It's about your heart. How prepared am I? It is said in the month of visitation, but some of us are very busy. Hello? If our pastor now says he's coming, I have taken from Kaduna out of Lagos, and I said, when are you coming? He said, I'm coming on Friday. And then that same Friday, I got busy, maybe I travel to a fiber. If you come, will you meet me? No. Last week, he was talking about positioning. Praise the Lord. So, if you are expecting a visitation, you must be positioned at the right place. My prayer for you is that you will not be found one day in this mode of visitation.
Amen.
The visitor will not come to your house and at the wrong location. He will meet meet you at the very point of expectation. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Divine visitation. When God visits, there is always a turnaround. When God visits, there is always a displacement. As a matter of fact, when God wants to bless a man, he removes certain people from your life. Amen. When God wants to change the story and the life of a man, he brings in, he positions certain people into your life also. Praise God. In other words, God's visitation brings about displacement and blessings. Amen. He visits you empty and leaves you loaded. When he visits you loaded with a wrong store, he will empty your wrong store and fill you with the right ones. Sometimes I was talking about Zacchaeus. I was reading from a pastor on Friday, the Living Bible, the Bible said he was a notorious sinner. That he was well known. Amen. Because if you understand, you are reading the word notorious, somebody like well known for something bad, evil. He was a notorious sinner. He was not qualified to be visited by God. But he had failed himself. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He did what? He had failed himself. Your ability is good, while the ability is better. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You are able, but you are not available is the body. Amen. Praise the Lord. I was discussing with a pastor sometime. I said, the problem that is plaguing the church today, especially the Pentecostal, is that people that are able but not faithful are placed in the helm of affairs. They give responsibility to able people that are not faithful. Either of the work is going to be stagnated. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you carry responsibility and give an unfaithful person, the Bible says it's like crossing a leaf that is out of judgment. And when a leaf is out of judgment, it's not carry. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When responsibility is placed on you and you are not picking up, you are becoming a body. I don't know if somebody is getting me. That word called responsibility is a demand placed on your ability. Praise the Lord. When a demand is placed on your ability and you respond to it, that's the responsibility. Responding to the demand that is placed on your ability. So when a demand is placed on your ability and you are not responding to it, what is that called? Irresponsibility. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
If God must visit us in this mode of visitation, we must be responsible. We must be responsible. I mean, if you remember, I said something, Pastor said this morning, it's not about the cash, whether you have it or not, that makes you a wealthy or a rich person. And I said some people back here that God does not require your background to give you a bank of the land. Amen. It's not about where you are coming from. It's not about whether your grandparents may give a charge tomorrow. That's what we're talking about. It's about responding to the demand that is placed on your ability. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Is it enough that went and hid himself in the bush? Praise God.
Hallelujah.
This is something about the situation. When God wants to visit you everywhere. Amen.
Amen.
Did not went and hid himself. Amen. And what happened? When the visitation of God came, man visitation, he heard the voice right there he was sitting. That mighty man of God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
When they say mighty man, he was speaking. The mighty man of God. Most of you are not getting the source, you cannot explain. You don't understand, that's why you are dumb. Amen.
Amen.
If you know what you carry, oh my God. It is ignorance that makes baby dragons to fly for fire. You really understand what I'm talking about. Praise God. There is a natural deposit of fire in the inside of the dragon. So, but when the baby dragon is ignorant, then you go about looking for the fire. I'm excited about the fire. Can I have some? No! You don't need external fire. You have fire in your nation. The position of Baba God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So it is ignorance. There's an adage in our life, listen, Sonny. That's a Baba God. That's a Baba God. That it is ignorance that makes a visitor to drink baking water. Because it's ignorance about the people. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
When God visits, he doesn't need anybody to visit the way he made them. Genesis 17. Genesis 17. God does not visit anybody and the university the way he makes it. There's always a turnaround in people's lives that are visited by God. Genesis 17 from verse 1. And when Abraham was 90 years old and nigh, the Lord appeared to Abraham and said unto him, I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect. And I will make my covenant between me and thee. And I will multiply thee exceedingly. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When the Lord appeared, he visited. Amen.
Amen.
And he said, I am the Lord God Almighty. You might have seen my mighty people, mighty gods of the earth, but I am the Almighty. Every other mighty is under me. He subjected to me. Walk before me and be thou perfect. Amen.
Amen.
When he visited, then look at what he did. He said, I will make my covenant between me and thee, and I will multiply thee exceedingly. In other words, whatever Abraham was having before, God is saying, I'm going to trouble it. Praise God. So when God visits you, he doesn't give you the business. He said, I'm going to enter a covenant with you. And that's why when God started this ministry, he said something. If you are not connected to Christ, you are not born again. Everything he said, you cannot be particular of it. Amen. If you are a true child of God, born again, spiritually, you are part of God's covenant person. You have got a covenant between you and God. And one of the things that follows that covenant is multiplication. Praise God. It doesn't leave you empty, it multiplies you. Amen. Walk before me and be thou perfect. Let's suggest what he did to Abraham when he visited. I am showing you this so that when God visits you, there will be an evidence that nobody can deny. An evidence that anybody that wants to ask you about it is so clear that you keep his mouth shut. God is going to give you a mouth-shutting evidence this morning. That amen is suffering from epilepsy.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Good. Verse 3. You see? Another thing happened here, just like it happened to Zacchaeus in Luke chapter 19. Verse 3 says, and Abraham fell on his face and talked, and God talked with him, saying, as for me, behold, my covenant is with thee, and thou shalt be the father of many nations. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Listen now.
Yeah.
My covenant as for me. The covenant I want to enter with you is to multiply you and even the things you think you don't have to be mastered over them. Amen. That shall be a father of many nations. It's not only about your locality. Our Papa will always tell us without us. His destiny is in the hands of God. He has traveled round the world. You may come from his village. Praise God. Hallelujah. It's not about your locality. It's about what he has chosen to do with your life. Amen. I will make you father of many nations. In other words, I'm going to make you an overseer. You will be right where you are and detecting the pulse of happenings around the world. They will be coming to you. Why? Because they will submit themselves to you by Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I will make you the father of many nations. Take note. When that promise was given to him, he had no single child. Amen. Praise the Lord. As a matter of fact, he was at the state of papi posh. If there is any word like that, papi papa posh. Amen. But God came and said, I will make you the father of nations. The most important thing is for you to obey yourself first. Then when it comes, divine visitation brings about transformation. Praise God. Divine visitation brings about translation. You are translated from this realm to another realm. How many of you know that Abraham did not go to adopt a child? Amen. He did it. At that age, I will make you the father of many nations. What has God told you? So for people told you that you are a great man. For all the kind of things you are having is among people of low estate, if there is anyone like that. And then you are getting confused. It's not God that spoke to me. He's not the author of confusion. Amen.
Amen.
If God has said it, yours is to believe. And then you'll be settled.
Amen.
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 It doesn't matter how long you believe that it will come to pass. Amen. Has God said anything to you and you are still not going? Friends, don't give it up. Keep pressing hard. Amen.
Amen.
If he says, go this way, I am going to give you this at the end of the day, or you are going to become this at the end of the day. Don't help God to become what he has asked you to be. He will bring you to pass by himself. Somebody didn't hear what I just said now.
Amen.
Don't help God to become what He wants you to be. He will bring it to pass. He's able. Amen.
Amen.
He was able to make it happen. I think of making it happen for somebody here.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Don't help me. Abraham, we are talking about ministry. He helped God. Amen. Even though people are putting the blame to say that, that he was one that pushed him to do what he did, and he got the seed. But that was not the seed of promise. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You may help God to fulfill what he has promised to do in your life and get results, but that is not the real result. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said one day that if you are believing God for red shoes, go and get red polish and brush for your red shoes. Amen.
Amen.
I said if God gives you, so if you got black shoes, that's what you ask God for. Am I correct? You are not going to throw the black one away, but keep holding on because what you ask him for the red is not the matter of confusion. You can't ask God for red shoes and he gives you black. Somebody help me. But some of us come say, Lord, and the problem we have all the time is that most of us are not being specific when we are asking God for things. Oh God, give me Suzuki Kawasaki Yamaha. That is confusing. Amen. What do you want? This Suzuki? Tell me, Lord, I need Suzuki right. When you say, Lord, give me the gift of a sight of the man, even if you go to where they are manufactured, it's a confusion. And which one is that? This is Honda, right? And you should give me the gift of a sight of the man. The man will say, hello, Safiya, can you perform with me? There's an emergency here. So most times we ask God for things scattered. And then when he talks to them, people here are coming. What do you want God to do for you? When he visited Abraham and he got talking with him, Abraham was overwhelmed and he went on his face. When he visited Zacchaeus, what happened? Zacchaeus was overwhelmed and he said, Lord, half of my goods are given to the poor. And if I find out that I have defrauded any man four times, I will pay back. So, whenever God visits people, that is always an overwhelming experience. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That is always what an overwhelming experience. When they visited Daniel, what happened? He was knocked down. Praise God. Daniel was knocked down and he spoke to him. When he visited the widow of Zelophehad, she was not left empty. Is somebody hearing me? When he visited our father in the Lord of blessed memory, Archbishop Idahosa, he took him around the world. This was someone that was having challenges with education. Challenge with his health. That they have to bubble him and drop in the dustbin. I'm not going to show you. Few persons. When God visits you as the rejected, you become projected.
Amen.
Amen. The rejected becomes projected when God visits. Pick him from the donkey and make him become the voice to the nation. Friends, I want to announce to you that when God visits, men may make efforts to stop your voice, but the only thing they can succeed in doing is to stop an echo. They can silence your voice. Amen.
Amen.
Tap your chest, say, my voice shall be heard this morning.
My voice shall be heard this morning.
I thought we began forgiveness this Sunday school. Tap your chest, but we are not speaking at all. I said, tap your chest and say, my voice shall be heard this morning.
My voice shall be heard this morning.
Because the Lord is visiting my home.
Because the Lord has visited my home.
Amen. What you want me to do, God perfect, because the covenant in me, and say, I'm making you father of nations. He now goes to tell me that when God visits a nobody, he makes him become somebody. There is no failure with God. Amen.
Amen.
No failure with God. When God visits, the reason why most of us struggle when God visits is disobedience. I was saying on Friday in a meeting, I said, if your long so many years friend is coming from abroad, I said, please come to the airport and pick me up. And then you go to the airport and you sat there, you are sitting waiting for him, and you step up and he landed. Praise God. Supposedly there was no problem. Because your pastor is down. How will you locate if you are not allowed? And then, suddenly, while he was landing, he now saw after all the day I didn't care he was coming. And then that one asked him, what time? Good to have you. When did you come to that? What's going to get you? He said, I'm expecting somebody is coming to pick me money. He said, no. Sit down, I'm taking it to my own house. What has happened? There was a diversion. Praise God. There was a diversion. Because you may not get anything, even though you said you were waiting. Somebody has had to give you his face. Tell me now, what will happen? All the goodies he gave you from abroad, where will they depart them? This fortunate person, am I correct? He was not coming for that person, for that person now has him. Everything he has, you will not be baptized. And so, okay, in the next 1 week, when I go, I will bring this. Whatever he has, he brings it and say, this is the yo-yo-yo I have for you people. So, in this month of divine visitation, your sensitivity will determine your activity. How sensitive you are. Would you tell me the kind of activity you engage yourself in? Praise God. Hallelujah. If God then is coming, I get it. But you are nowhere to be found. We have a new being this morning when God is still on board. Will you be at the right place or in the wrong place? If he comes to you, find you at home waiting for him, or at the airport expecting his arrival, just like the five virgins, fully 10 virgins, 5 minutes and 5 wives, they were awaiting the visitor. Some of them were not sensitive and they missed out. The sensitive ones, we are able to welcome and accommodate the visitor. The insensitive ones now end up becoming beggars. Oh my God, it will not be your portion this morning.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
They had good